The first is based upon the control of the reaction, and the second upon the sudden release of all controls. In the wartime development of atomic energy, the United States obtained the cooperation of hundreds of scientists born in Germany, Russia, Italy, Hungary, Denmark, France, England, and many other countries. The United States can make an enormous contribution to this development as part of a great cooperative effort. But the genius of science is worldwide. Any attempt to go it alone and in secret would soon result only in the impoverishment of our own science. Armed conflict in an atomic energy world is certain suicide. It is clear today that the future of the world will depend more than ever before on the development of science. The scientific research of the world will have to be combined, guided, and crystallized for the benefit of all mankind. For today we are on the threshold of an era of abundance, and we must not permit those who hold the key for the time being, for one reason or another, to obstruct the way to general happiness. We do not have to have social revolutions. We do not have to have wars. We have been given, through the fantastic discovery of atomic energy, the unique opportunity to build one single human community on the highest spiritual level, accompanied by unlimited material facilities.
We can war.
And the final state of man will be 10 times as miserable as it has ever been. We must move with speed, determination, and faith. The stakes are the human race. We cannot fail. We cannot delay. The awe-inspiring responsibility is ours for a short time only. The war we won was a people's war. The peace we win must be a people's peace.